Since the Arab Spring in 2011, the Assad regime of Syria has been aggressively attacking its own citizens. In the past 6 years, the conflict has been referred to as a Syrian civil war. The constant struggle between Syrian government, Kurdish and Syrian rebel groups, and radical Islamic terrorist organizations has led to the displacement of roughly 11 million people. Syria has consistently violated the human rights of its own people and committed numerous war crimes throughout the 6 years of ongoing conflict. These violations have sadly led to horrendous outcomes like the death of children like Alon Kurdi. Alon was 3 years old when humanity refused him a place in this world. He is not only a result of the war in Syria, but also of the failure by the rest of the world to find the compassion to open their borders. Sadly, Alon is not the only one. In January of 2011, just months before violence broke out, my family and I visited Syria for pilgrimage of our Shia Islamic roots. Within these 2 weeks, we witnessed the kindness and hospitality of the Syrian people, along with the beautiful sights from masjids to mountains. It only occurs to me now how the children behind me are probably dead. So where are they all going? Today, the conditions in Syria are so dangerous and life-threatening that Syrians are finding refuge and asylum in numerous other countries. 2.6 million have fled to Turkey, 1 million to Lebanon, and 650,000 to Jordan. Yet these countries don't have nearly enough resources or even the financial stability to actually support these vulnerable people. When the number of Syrian refugees granted refugee status or asylum in Turkey, Lebanon, and Jordan is compared to those of first world countries, one begins to wonder why so many nations choose to turn a blind eye. These more affluent countries have better infrastructure and resources for Syrians to thrive and to create new lives, yet they refuse to open their borders. Living conditions in refugee camps in Lebanon and Turkey are miserable and lack the ability to substantially improve the living condition that these refugees already endure. Many deal with mental and physical traumas due to experiencing war conditions in their homes. However, these are often overlooked due to limited resources. How do we expect these people to build new lives and become active citizens in their new homes if they are consistently marginalized wherever they go? We can see that even in countries that have policies in place to protect Syrian refugees, often carry out poor procedures. Turkey, for example, has an open door policy that allows all Syrian refugees to seek refuge. But recently, Turkish border control has been beating and murdering those who tried to cross. Within the past year, 60 Syrians, including women and children, have died at the hands of Turkish border control. These refugees are not only being taken advantage of by their own governments, but by those all over the world. So what happens if we do nothing? Even once Syrians are in refugee camps, some are still assaulted, raped, and murdered. It is when people are so mistreated and marginalized that radical Islamic groups are able to overtake governments and establish tyrannical rule. First world countries are scared to let these harmless women and children in because they may be terrorists. But the real danger is letting the Syrian civil war escalate, because then will our fears become our realities. Syria is not just a Syria problem. It is a problem on all of our shoulders, and one day, history will tell the tale of how humanity failed to protect those who had nowhere else to turn. Thank you.